Hello, and welcome to this video about rotation. In this video, we will explore the rotation of a figure about a point. Let's learn about rotations. Rotations are everywhere you look. The Earth is the most common example, rotating about an axis. The wheel on a car or a bicycle rotates about the center bolt. These two examples rotate 360 degrees. There are other forms of rotation that are less than a full 360 degree rotation, like a character or an object being rotated in a video game. More formally speaking, a rotation is a form of transformation that turns a figure about a point. We call this point the center of rotation. A figure and its rotation maintain the same shape and size, but will be facing a different direction. A figure can be rotated clockwise or counterclockwise. Another great example of rotation in real life is a Ferris wheel, where the center hub is the center of rotation. The measure of the amount a figure is rotated about the center of rotation is called the angle of rotation. The angle of rotation is usually measured in degrees. We specify the degree measure and direction of a rotation. Here is a figure rotated 90 degrees clockwise and counterclockwise about a center point. A great math tool that we use to show rotations is the coordinate grid. Let's start by looking at rotating a point about the center 0, 0. If you take a coordinate grid and plot a point, and then rotate the paper 90 degrees or 180 degrees clockwise or counterclockwise about the origin, you can find the location of the rotated point. Let's look at a real example. Here we plotted point A at 5, 6. Then we rotated the paper 90 degrees clockwise to create point A prime, which is at 6, negative 5. Here is the same point A at 5, 6, rotated 180 degrees counterclockwise about the origin to get A prime at negative 5, negative 6. Let's take a closer look at the two rotations from our experiment. In our first experiment, when we rotate point A 90 degrees clockwise about the origin to create point A prime, the y value of point A became the x value of point A prime. And the x value of point A became the y value of point A prime, but with the opposite sign. In our second experiment, point A is rotated 180 degrees counterclockwise about the origin to create A prime, where the x and y values are the same as point A, but with opposite signs. Lucky for us, these experiments have allowed mathematicians to come up with rules for the most common rotations on a coordinate grid, assuming that the origin is 0, 0 as the center of rotation. Here are the rotation rules. If you want to rotate a figure 90 degrees clockwise about the origin, you take the coordinate points x, y, and they become y, negative x. If you want to rotate it 90 degrees counterclockwise, you take the points x, y, and they become negative y, x. If you want to rotate 180 degrees clockwise or counterclockwise, then you take x, y, and it becomes negative x, negative y. If you want to rotate the figure 270 degrees clockwise, take the point x, y, and make it negative y, x. And if you want to rotate it 270 degrees counterclockwise, take the point x, y, and change it to y, negative x. As you can see, our two experiments follow these rules. Now that we know how to rotate a point, let's look at rotating a figure on the coordinate grid. To rotate triangle ABC about the origin 90 degrees clockwise, we would follow the rule x, y becomes y, negative x, where the y value of the original point becomes the new x value, and the x value of the original point becomes the new y value with the opposite sign. Let's apply the rule to the vertices to create the new triangle A prime, B prime, C prime. So point A, negative 4, 7, becomes A prime, 7, 4. Point B, negative 6, 1, becomes B prime, 1, 6. And point C, negative 2, 1, becomes C prime, 1, 2. Let's take a look at another rotation. Let's rotate triangle ABC 180 degrees about the origin counterclockwise. Although rotating a figure 180 degrees clockwise and 180 degrees counterclockwise uses the same rule, which is xy becomes negative x, negative y, where the coordinates of the vertices of the rotated triangle are the coordinates of the original triangle with the opposite sign. Let's apply the rule to the vertices to create the new triangle A prime, B prime, C prime. Point A, 2, 7 becomes point A prime, negative 2, negative 7. Point B, 2, 1 becomes the point B prime, negative 2, negative 1. And point C, 6, 1 becomes the point C prime, negative 6, negative 1. Here is quadrilateral A, B, C, D. to rotate quadrilateral ABCD 90 degrees counterclockwise about the origin, we will use the rule xy becomes negative yx. Let's apply the rules to the vertices to create the quadrilateral A prime, B prime, C prime, D prime. So point A, negative 8, negative 2 becomes point A prime, 2, negative 8. Point B, negative 7, negative 7 becomes point B prime, 7, negative 7. Point C, negative 2, negative 6 becomes point C prime, 6, negative 2. And point D, negative 3, negative 2 becomes point D prime, 2, negative 3. Now I want you to try some practice problems on your own. Kite KLMN is shown on the coordinate grid. The kite has been rotated about the origin to create kite K prime, L prime, M prime, N prime. Can you identify which rotation of kite KLMN created kite K prime, L prime, M prime, N prime? Let's start by identifying the coordinates of the vertices of kite KLMN and of our rotated kite. Point K was negative 8, 3, and it became K prime, 8, negative 3. Point L was negative 5, 5, and became point L prime, 5, negative 5. Point M was negative 2, 3, and became point M prime, 2, negative 3. And point N was negative 5, negative 3, and became point N prime, 5, 3. A closer look at the coordinates of the vertices shows the coordinates of K prime, L prime, M prime, N prime are the same as the vertices of the original kite, but with the opposite sign. Let's look at the rules. The only rule where the values of the x and y don't switch, but their sign changes, is the 180 degree rotation. For a 90 degree clockwise rotation, xy becomes y negative x. For a 90 degree counterclockwise rotation, xy becomes negative yx. For a 180 degree clockwise and counterclockwise rotation, xy becomes negative x, negative y. For a 270 degree clockwise rotation, xy becomes negative yx. And for a 270 degree counterclockwise rotation, xy becomes y negative x. Therefore, kite KLMN was rotated 180 degrees about the origin to create kite K prime, L prime, M prime, N prime. Let's look at another problem. Pentagon QRSTU is shown on the coordinate grid. Rotate the pentagon QRSTU 90 degrees counterclockwise to create the pentagon Q prime, R prime, S prime, T prime, U prime. Let's start by finding the coordinates of the vertices of our original pentagon. The rule for 90 degree counterclockwise rotation is xy becomes negative yx. Let's apply the rule to find the vertices of our new pentagon. Point Q, negative 6, 6, becomes Q prime, negative 6, negative 6. Point R, negative 4, 7, becomes point R prime, negative 7, negative 4. Point S, 0, 4, becomes point S prime, negative 4, 0. Point T, negative 4, 1, becomes point T prime, negative 1, negative 4. Point U, negative 6, 2, becomes point U prime, negative 2, negative 6. One last practice problem. Trapezoid PQRS, where P is negative 3, negative 5, Q is 3, negative 5, R is 5, negative 2, and S is negative 5, negative 2, is rotated 90 degrees clockwise about the origin to create trapezoid P prime, Q prime, R prime, S prime. Create both trapezoids on the coordinate grid. We will start by deciding which rule to use for the 90 degrees clockwise rotation about the origin. We're going to use xy becomes y negative x. Now let's apply this rule to the coordinates of the vertices of PQRS. Point P, negative 3, negative 5, becomes point P prime, negative 5, 3. Point Q, 3, negative 5, becomes point Q prime, negative 5, negative 3. Point R, 5, negative 2, becomes point R prime, negative 2, negative 5. Point S, negative 5, negative 2, becomes point S prime, negative 2, 5. Now let's plot these points and create the trapezoids on the coordinate grid. I hope that this overview of rotation was helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.